The green light is given for humanitarian aid to be delivered to the besieged Palestinian enclave of Gaza. This positive development in the Israel-Hamas war is clouded by the death of yet another Filipino in the conflict. Zen Hernandez has tonight's top story.
There is no let-up in the airstrikes on Gaza. The bombardment also targeting Rafah in the south, where a border crossing heading to Egypt remained closed. On day 13 of Israel's war against Hamas, the Philippine government received confirmation of a fourth Filipino fatality. The victim, a female caregiver, was one of three missing Filipinos. The Foreign Affairs Department declined to reveal her name, since her parents have yet to be informed.
We cannot confirm if she was first abducted and then killed, but it was because of the Hamas attack. She was one of the three missing Filipinos that we were hoping to find. So that means four casualties now and two more missing.
The remains of the fourth fatality has yet to be turned over to Philippine authorities, while the papers for the two other victims are being processed. The cremated remains of another Filipino is expected to be brought home next month. The DFA says no Filipinos were killed nor injured in the deadly explosion at the Al Ali Arab Hospital, since all Filipino residents in Gaza heeded Israel's instructions to relocate to the south. Officials say the Filipinos are staying 15 minutes away from the Rafah border crossing, the sole exit to Egypt. The DFA is optimistic that foreign nationals will be allowed safe passage soon after U.S. President Joe Biden's visit to Israel.
Because the Israelis have always said, be ready at any time because it could be at any day. And when it's open, it's not a permanent, it will not be a permanent opening.
For now, the Rafah border crossing will be opened to allow the entry of humanitarian aid to Gaza. According to Egyptian President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi, he agreed to open the Rafah border crossing following a call from U.S. President Biden, as both leaders look to bring relief to civilians caught in the conflict. Biden says part of the agreement is to make sure that aid reaches civilians. The two leaders also agreed to help in preventing the conflict from escalating. An initial 20 trucks are expected to arrive in Gaza on Friday. Biden has also committed a $100 million funding for humanitarian assistance in Gaza and the West Bank. Russia also sent aid, mostly food supplies, to Egypt to be sent to Gaza. In the meantime, international response on the Israel-Hamas war has been broadly split as protests erupt in various countries, including the Philippines. A Filipino-Jewish community gathered Thursday at the Philippine-Israel Friendship Marker at the Quezon Memorial Circle to show support for Israel.
Stop killing the kids! Stop the war! And free Palestine! Stop being!
While thousands of Bangsamoro in Cotabato called for Palestine's freedom.
We are not defending the Palestinian people. We are defending the all oppressed people of the world.
Protesters in Marawi also appealed for a ceasefire. The DFA says while the Philippines supports Israel's right to self-defense, it condemns the killing and hurting of civilians and violations of the international humanitarian law. 3,480 have died and over 12,000 have been injured in Israel's siege of Gaza. 2 million people have been displaced with no power, water, and food, while hospitals are on the brink of collapse. More than 200 Israeli and foreign hostages are still being held hostage by Hamas. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.